once you know your area of interest, you just have to rely on the process. You just have to trust the system. You will get ample set of opportunities at the end of the program. So I think the 1 year that I spent with Great Lakes was quite transformational for me. I came from an engineering, hardcore engineering background, and eventually transitioned into the world of business. I moved into a sales and BD role with a high octane fintech startup, and eventually to Microsoft, one of the largest companies on the planet.
Currently, now I'm working with GS as a business operations associate consultant in their operations domain.
I was always keen on doing an MBA, and as I said, after having worked for 3.5 years in the industry, I realized that I need to go back to upskill myself. I opted for the 1 year program because it would provide me the necessary skills. Along with that, I will be able to move back to the industry faster.
I wanted to solely move to the consultant side of the business.
As you're aware, it's a 1 year PGPM program, and I came with a certain amount of work ex already as a part of my resume, and I wanted to get back into the workforce as early as possible, right? So there were a few fundamentals already in place, coming from a corporate background with 3 years amount of work ex, and more importantly, I think it was extremely important for me to be a part of a class structure which would have candidates coming in with a similar nature of background. So if you see the 1 year PGPM program, the class composition is typically within a range of like 3 to 5 years of work ex. And I also wanted to get back into the workforce as early as possible. So these two factors were predominantly the whole and soul of IA joining Great Lakes in the 1 year PGPM program.
So I would say it was a mix of all of them, but primarily it was that I already at that point had a 2.5 years of work ex, working both in India and outside. So I had more or less a foundational knowledge of how the industry works, what are the different nuances of a business and all. So I did not want to go into learning from directly from scratch, which is usually what happens in a 2 year program. You go into much more depth, but I just wanted an overview, a good overview. And that is what GLIM offers, the GLIM PGPM course especially, it offers. It won't be teaching you every basic thing, but it will be holistic enough to cover everything that you would require coming from a experienced background.
PGPM program has a minimum requirement of 2 year work experience. And having 3.5 years of work experience, I got to know that I'll be amongst a cohort that would be more experienced, or at least having a minimum of 2 years of experience. And since the people are from vast backgrounds and work experience across various domains, so that is what most attracted me.
Till now we have analytics is one of the important elements and highlights of Great Lakes. So we have already done our BA classes, business analytics, and we have been extensively coding in R, which is kind of the industry standard. And this year we have business intelligence. So in software front as well, we are using Tableau, SPSS. So all these stuffs, which are basically something that even most of the JDs, even if you see, have a set of requirements which kind of align with the course is more curated in a way it matches the kind of industry standards that are right now.
This transition to a fintech startup was again because of Great Lakes and its curriculum. As a part of the curriculum in itself, we are supposed to do live projects. And that's when this organization came in with a business problem that we were supposed to solve. It was a 6 month long project where we had to devise a go-to-market strategy for the organization that we were working for the products and services for the Southeast Asian region. And that went really well. And by the end of that problem statement, the founders of the organizations were really happy with the work. And even before the placements would begin, they would say, okay, we'll save you the time, we'll save you the pain. Once you are done with your curriculum, why don't you join us? Right. So that's how my journey into the world of fintech started, my journey into the world of business started, and thanks to Great Lakes for providing me that opportunity. And this transition and the way I evolved as an individual from dealing with mid-scale companies, startups, etc., all the way to enterprises, is something which caught the eyeball of Microsoft, right? As you are aware, Microsoft has multiple products. Many of them are SaaS offerings. It's one of the reasons why, you know, I had just one or two conversations with them and they found that, okay, we have synergies with this individual. Why don't we bring him on board?
My primary focus was going into consulting. That is what I wanted to do if I ever did an MBA, to go into a business analyst or a consulting role. And ZS was one of the top companies who was offering that role. And I actually targeted it from the very beginning. I would say even before I started my program in GLIM, I had started preparing for ZS. And the process, I would say the recruitment process in ZS is a very structured process. So it has the case study rounds, the guesstimate, the CV. They will test you on each of the parameters. And I would say a last moment preparation is most likely to fall short. So I was targeting it. I had targeted it from around 5 to 6 months. I was preparing for it daily. So I was not taking too much pressure because the schedule here is also pretty, I would say, there is a heavy workload here. So I kind of balanced it. And as I took that time to prepare, so it made me kind of comfortable, pretty comfortable at the end. But still, I was nowhere, I would say, prepared for the process on that day, because it was a 6 hours experience for me over 3 rounds. And again, it becomes difficult when the interview is happening virtually for 6 hours. And I had to solve the case study also virtually. So it's a different experience when you solve something with a pen and paper and the interviewer sitting in front of you. And one more thing is about ZS, I would say, they don't hire too much, but they hire a candidate who they see as a right fit for the role that they are hiring. So for me, I think all those rounds were about trying to find that right fit. And there was no round where I had just a general discussion. All the discussions across the round were pretty meaningful.
Well, in my opinion, the companies look for candidates who have certain sort of expertise prior hand. They look for people who have already worked in corporates, who know the nitty-gritties and of the business environment. We have companies like Deloitte, Accenture, ZS. And apart from that, from the analytics domain, we have Tiger Analytics, Mu Sigma. And I was looking for a company where I could leverage my leadership skills. And I'm fortunate enough to have been placed in Accenture ATCI, wherein I have been placed as the team lead for the cloud design, which is the major trend nowadays.
I was having an expectation that I will be getting into that space as well. And the placement season started off pretty well. And like major companies, like all the MNCs, like from Deloitte to Accenture to all of them, they have started, like even ZS, all of them started coming, and I was kind of aiming for that consultant role. And eventually I have got into Virtusa. So that also, fortunately, I have also cracked the consultant role as well there. So what I personally, for me, what I had come up with in my mind to go and take out of this MBA journey, I have successfully done from the placement point of view.
So I have a specific set of managed customers, corporate customers that I manage for Microsoft from an overall business relationship perspective. So my role is more of orchestration, right? I come within a team, I have a team of technical and functional specialists across the entire Microsoft stack. And my role is to understand the key business problems and pain points of the businesses that I'm managing. Lucky for me, you know, Great Lakes had some amazing set of electives like critical thinking, organizational behavior, business communications, right? All of these are very relevant to what we do on a day-to-day basis with my set of customers.
I would say that before joining, I too had a lot of questions, but I would really suggest is don't come with any preconceived notions that you will be going for this majors, you'll going for this minors. Don't come with that preconceived notions. Get a hang of the course in the first 2 terms, first 3 terms, and then decide accordingly based on your interest. Don't go with the herd, just pursue your interest and you will be done.
Once you know your area of interest, you just have to rely on the process. You just have to trust the system. You will get ample set of opportunities at the end of the program.